الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين كفروا وصدوا عن سبيل الله أضل أعمالهم. والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وآمنوا بما نزل على محمد وهو الحق من ربهم كفر عنهم سيئاتهم وأصلح بالهم. ذلك بأن الذين كفروا اتبعوا الباطل وأن الذين آمنوا اتبعوا الحق من ربهم. كذلك يضرب الله للناس أمثالهم. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
Beneficent and most merciful. Those who disbelieve and hinder others from the way of Allah, Allah destroys their actions. And those who embrace faith and do pious works persistently and believe in this book which has been revealed to Muhammad, blessings and peace be upon him, and that is the very truth from their Lord. Allah erases their evil works from their record of deeds and refines their states of being. That is because those who disbelieve follow falsehood and those who believe follow the truth to sent down from their Lord. That is how Allah illustrates for people their states of being.
I do want to emphasize here that we are all here with our families. We are going to protest very peacefully in a very organized manner in the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We are vehemently denouncing this particular movie and all attempts by the past people as well, like Salman Rushdie, as well as the Danish cartoonist, to insult Islam and insult Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So let's start our program today with a few slogans and then we'll have the tilawat. Please repeat after me, and inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching and he will hear us as well. Nara-e Takbir! Nara-e Takbir! Nara-e Risalat! Nara-e Risalat! Labbaik ya Muhammad! Labbaik ya Muhammad! لبيك يا محمد لبيك يا محمد لبيك يا محمد لا إله إلا الله. I will say لا إله إلا الله, you say محمد رسول الله. لا إله إلا الله. Learn the Quran. So we have a long series, and then we have a number of media institutions that have made it a fashion to bash Muslims, to bash Islam, to spread Islamophobia in the society. So I'm going to repeat, and please repeat after me, so that the Americans can hear that the only power that we are afraid of is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is only one superpower in the world, and that is Allah, and we will not accept the American efforts to defame Islam, to spread Islamophobia. Shame, shame, USA!
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 In addition to the United States, we also know that the Zionist media and the people who are supported by the Zionist ideology continue to write, to continue to say reports. Even in this country, you will see those media reports, even about the rally today, and they will try to portray us as savages and terrorists and people who are spreading hate. Although we are standing here, we have signed here that say, I love Jesus because I'm a Muslim. I love Muhammad because I'm a Muslim. I love Moses because I'm a Muslim. So again, we are not against any particular sect or any particular religion. We are standing here against hate speech, and we denounce the United States and Israel for creating this culture of Islamophobia in the world. So again, repeat after me. Shame, shame, Israel!
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 Shame, shame, USA!
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 Down with racism!
Down with racism!
Down with racism!
Down with racism!
Down with Islamophobia!
Down with Islamophobia!
Nara Takbir!
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. This poem is for Prophet Muhammad, and the reason why I converted to Islam was from Prophet Muhammad and from his daughter Fatima Zahra. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Ya Rasulullah, you were sent as a mercy for mankind in order to follow your roots as well as your vine. No one has ever been called Habib Allah except for you, Rasulullah. To have such respect and honor to be called my love is the greatest honor from the Lord above. Yes, you have been chosen out of Allah's creation to give all humanity Allah's revelation. You taught peace and purification, to also stay away from alcohol drinks and fornication. To be humble and have cleanliness is one step closer to Allah's oneness. Your motto was preaching the truth, and not only by words but by example. That is a great sample. Everyone knows actions are louder than words. It is written from the Lord above. You had such patience and tolerance for all those people who had hate and ignorance. When Allah sent down the angel Gabriel to ask if you wanted the mountains to crush the people, instead you wept and prayed and asked Allah to forgive them. You didn't take it personal. Instead, you were noble. Now that is how you showed wisdom. We must follow that in order to get to your kingdom. You taught us the importance to take care of orphans and give poor zakah, as well as our salah and rakah. Fasting is a form of discipline, patience, and tolerance. It is so rewarding and gives us mercy and bountiness. We must follow the commandments sent from Allah. Once in our life, have to perform pilgrimage and become Hajiya or Haji. That is stamped and sealed and used when we are judged. To believe in Nabi Rasulullah as our prophet and messenger stems from the heart is the beginning of love so grand. You just can't imagine. Ya Rasulullah, you are the light in our graves, as well as we are only a simple slave. No, you were the prophet of purification. That is why you were chosen to lead all nations to Islam and salvation through Allah's revelation. That is how you got the name Al-Amin and Habib Allah. Allah.
La ilaha. La ilaha illallah. لبيك يا محمد
لبيك يا محمد
لبيك يا محمد
لبيك يا محمد.
Okay, we have just have two or three more speakers, and then we'll be ending the rally in a very peaceful, disciplined manner. I just want to share some
and the mercy on the mankind, Prophet Muhammad. Nare Takbir. نارا التكبير نارا الرسالة And who spread this hate if we have to spend shame on them
Shame, shame USA
Shame, shame USA
And of course the Zionists
Shame, shame Zionism
Shame, shame USA.
Shame, shame USA. Shame, shame USA.
Shame, shame USA.
Shame, shame Israel.
Shame, shame Israel.
Okay, one announcement I would like to make is we do have some of the Zionist media present here as well. They're trying to reach out to people on that side and talk to them. I just want to clarify that the people who are the organizer, the Canadians Against Blasphemy, the spokesperson, Brother Zafar Bangash, is right here. If any media needs to speak for the official position of these organizers, because what they typically do is they'll go in there, they'll try to talk to a few people, and they'll try to get a little bit of a snap bite that they can go ahead and run a program on Sun TV then about how awful the Muslims are. So please be careful. Again, be disciplined about it, be organized about it. If you have any questions, if you are denounce anybody and say anything about anyone. We also would like to welcome the brothers from the Sikh community that have also joined us now, brothers from the Hindus community, and as well as our Christian and Jewish friends who are arriving. Some of them were stuck over in because of road construction. So alhamdulillah, they've all joined in. It's truly becoming an interfaith rally where we have Christian, Jews, Hindus, Sikhs, all together denouncing this particular motion. And we welcome them in the best of akhlaq of our Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah. Ya Rasulullah.
I know many people, they were saying that we can't make it, we shouldn't make it, because they were afraid, I don't know why. We just want to say that we have, we just want to tell our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, O Messenger of Allah, my blood, family, wealth, and everything I was given by God are sacrifices to your dignity, veneration, and honor. Let the whole world hear these words. O Prophet, we die for you. My soul and my blood are at your service. Allah is a witness to what we say. The blood of our martyrs, the wounds of our injured, our demolished homes, all witness. We will sacrifice everything for your sake, O Prophet. Ya Rasulallah, fidaka nafsi wa dami. وأبي وأمي وأهلي وولدي وكل مالي وما خولني ربي فدا كرامتك وعرضك وشرفك فليسمع العالم إن دماءنا وأرواحنا وأولادنا وحياتنا ترخص أمام كرامة رسول الله وعرض رسول الله وشرف رسول الله والله على ما نقول شهيد ودماء شهدائنا تشهد وجراح جراحنا تشهد وبيوتنا المهدمة تشهد ما دام فينا دم لن نسكت عن إهانة نبينا وسيبقى الصوت عاليا لبيك يا رسول الله
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 صلوا على محمد وآل محمد Thank you
Here with me
No Beautiful part about here that we have all sects of Islam here we are going to recite a dua taught by us by the Prophet Please hold each other's hand whoever is next to you Please hold your hand and put it up and we'll recite dua in wahda It is a small dua like the sisters who hold hands of each other and brothers to hold their each other's hand and raise them up so the Americans can see that their conspiracy to divide the Muslims between different sects has failed miserably and we are all united in the love of our Prophet. You want to do the dua wahda? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
La ilaha illallah.
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 نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا إله إلا الله وحده 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 ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده وله الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون تكبير
الله أكبر الله أكبر
The largest rally held in the Western world. We have over 5,000 people, and I just saw the last bus that was stuck because of a road accident. They just arrived. Let's welcome them with Labbaik Ya Muhammad! Labbaik Ya Muhammad! Labbaik Ya Muhammad! Of the day from Iraq.
Assalamu alaykum wa
rahmatullahi.
Ansur nabiyyaka bit-tuqa.
Ansur nabiyyaka bit-tuqa.
Ansur habibaka bit-tamassik bil-huda. La tansur al-hadi ila din as-samahati wal-makarim bil-fadadati wal-rida. Anna an-nabiyya Muhammad شمس الحقيقة والفضيلة والندى أن لنفحة سافل متعفنا أن تحجب الشمس التي بشعاعها تحنو على هذا الوجود أن لقلب أسود أن يطمس القلب الودود الشمس شمسا دائمة مهما يبالغ بالأذى أهل الضغائن والعناد من اليهود
الله أكبر
يا أيها الباكي على عرض الرسول يا أيها الباكي على عرض الرسول بكاؤك الموصول في عصر الأذى حتما يطول الحاقدون طغوا وعاثوا واعتدوا واستهتروا فالطعن في الأطهار صار ثقافة تعمي العقول ودم المجازر في حمانا هادر مثل السيول فارجع إلى نور الهدى سلاحك الأخلاق في عصر العمى كن مؤمنا حقا ولا تقف الدماء كن طاهرا حرا أبيا مسلما عرض النبي محمد أعلى وأسمى من سفاهة حاقد أغلى وأقدس عن ضغينة حاسد عرض النبي محمد قد صانه رب السماء تكبير
الله
Okay brothers, we have concluded our program.
We'll never be defeated. The Muslims united. We'll never be defeated. The Muslims united. We'll never be defeated.
Brother Zafar Bangash.
Brothers and sisters, if I were to say that I want to thank you for coming out today, it will not be appropriate, because you, each and every one of you, have come out as your duty and as your love for the noble messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You fulfilled your duty today and you delivered a slap on the face of our enemies, whether they are in the United States or the Zionist state of Israel. They want to divide us. They want to create divisions amongst us. They want to call us different sects. They want to call us Shias and Sunnis. They go to the Sunnis and say, oh, the Shias are different from you. They go to the Shias and they tell them, oh, the Sunnis are different from you. But what do? Their purpose is, they don't even care for the Sunnis or Shias. They just want to rob you of your resources in the Muslim world. Sisters, I want you to make a pledge today for the love of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that you will not indulge in any divisive activities against your fellow Muslims, that when we stand together, this is the result that we achieve. When we stand together, we are like one ummah. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam called us one ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has called us one ummah. So why is it that we divide ourselves? I want you to make this pledge that we will work together, that we will not allow our minor differences to divide us, because that benefits nobody but the enemies of Islam and the enemies of Allah and the enemies of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is our responsibility to stand together. And I want to congratulate each and every one of you that you came out by the thousands. And here we see that not a tree leaf has been affected. This is the discipline, this is the dignity, this is the honor that Muslims have shown. Unlike those criminals that go with bombs, that go with missiles, that go with planes, and they kill innocent people around the world. We don't want to kill innocent people. But we will stand for our rights and our dignity and our honor. Brothers and sisters, I also want to let you know that we have heard that some people in Toronto are planning to bring this blasphemous movie to Toronto on October the 12th.
Yes.
And they're planning to bring that scoundrel by the name of Pastor Terry Jones, who organized Burn a Quran Day in Florida in September of 2010. I want you to know that we, all of us, on October the 12th, will come out and confront these terrorists, and we'll tell them that we will not allow you to insult our Prophet or our Deen or our Muslim Ummah. So please keep this in mind. Brothers and sisters, what I want you to do is to please keep your ears and eyes open for announcements for the October 12th event. We will, inshallah, let you know. This will be distributed through the internet, through email, through Facebook, and also through flyers. But I want you, please, to make this pledge that you will all come out, bring your families, not for your own sake, but for the sake of the honor of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that you have demonstrated today. So please, I ask you, do you give me this pledge that you will join us once again on October the 12th?
Inshallah!
Inshallah! Inshallah. And brothers and sisters, as I look around, I see brothers and sisters from all communities, whether they are from Africa or Asia or the Middle East or from North America or any other part of the world, or even our native sister who was here. This is a remarkable achievement by Muslims. But this is only possible when we stand united. So my brothers and sisters, I urge you, please, we as Muslims must stand united for our rights. And if you do so, I can guarantee you that we will achieve success in the mission that we have in life, that we will restore dignity to the Muslims, and we will prevent these corruptors from insulting our great and noble Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So brothers and sisters, once again, from every community, whether you are a Shia or a Sunni, or you are coming from this mosque or that mosque, you are welcome over here because you came for the honor of our great Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahu Akbar! Ya Rasulullah! Ya Rasulullah! Ya Rasulullah! So brothers and sisters, keep this in mind. Remember, this is not the end of our journey. Our journey is long. We will require many of us to make sacrifices. But I don't think that there is any sacrifice that is too great for us to offer for the honor of our great Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We need to make sure that each one of us remains on our toes. We need to make sure that we are on the scene. We need to make sure that we respond to our calls to come out and to defend our rights and our dignity. So brothers and sisters, once again, I urge all of you, keep October the 12th in mind. And inshallah, we will let you know exactly what the precise plan is. But for now, you have made history today. As Brother Adil said, this is the largest gathering of Muslims in North America. This is history that you have made today. I also want to send a message to the Canadian government and to our politicians here. I think it is a disgrace that not one elected official has condemned this filthy movie. I know if this had been directed against...
Shame on you!
Harper, Harper, shame on you!
Harper, Harper, shame on you!
Harper, Harper, shame on you!
Harper, Harper,
shame on you!
Harper, Harper, shame on you!
Brothers and sisters, if we remain united, we can kick this government out of office to send a message that the honor of our Prophet will not be tolerated, and that we will not tolerate disrespect to the honor of our great Prophet. So if we are united, we stand together, we can achieve a great deal. And I want you please to remember that it is your obligation, your religious obligation, your Islamic obligation, that you must always turn out in even greater numbers than this, so that we send a message to Ottawa and to Queen's Park and to City Hall that as Muslims, we are not going to allow anybody to walk over us. So make that pledge that you will come out, and let us conclude with Narae Takbir! Narae Takbir! Narae Takbir! Narae Risalat! Narae Risalat! Narae Risalat!
Hey everyone, I only, just for 1 minute please, I only want to...
لا إله إلا الله
محمد رسول الله
لا إله إلا الله
محمد رسول الله
لا إله إلا الله
محمد رسول الله
شيب شيب USA
شيب USA
شيب شيب USA
شيب USA
شيب شيب USA
make some announcement again, but Zafar Bangash is here. If there's any media that has any questions, he will be here to answer your questions. Brother Zafar Bangash, you can ask anybody wearing a jacket. After Brother Munir, we're going to disperse very peacefully, and we will show the akhlaq and seerah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We have made our point. We're going to come again on October 12th if Terry Jones is allowed to come here. But again, I request you to make sure the entire media is here, the world is watching, that we express our akhlaq and our seerah, and inshallah we get even more people next time. There are 150,000 Muslims that live in Toronto. We have alhamdulillah 6,000 to 7,000 here. We would like to get all 100,000 out here in the next protest. So Brother Munir, please make that announcement.
I see not even Muslim. I see there are people from Sikh faith, people Hindu faith, Christian, Jewish brothers, and all faith representing this hate mongers. So my slogan will be a little bit more, so the people united can never be defeated, then Muslim united. The people united
can never be defeated.
Are you tired?
No,
you are not tired.
No,
for the sake of Rasulullah. The people united
can never be defeated.
I can't see the hands on the back. The people united
can never be defeated.
Sayyidi, Sayyidi,
Ya Nabi, Ya Nabi,
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 Labbaik Ya Muhammad,
Labbaik Ya Muhammad,
Labbaik Ya Muhammad,
Labbaik Ya Muhammad.
And as Brother Zafar announced, if you can give me the community leader here from all the mosques, if you can give me your email, we will keep you posting inshallah on the next move. As you know that the hate mongers are coming to Toronto to show the film. So we have to show one last time inshallah for the sake of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that La ilaha illallah.
Labbaik Ya Rasul,
Labbaik Ya Rasul,
Labbaik Ya Rasul.
And we must know who is behind this. We have to know those hands who are creating this fitna against the Muslim and the people of the world, the oppressed people of the world. Those oppressors are one of them. The building in front of you. So with your all energy, say shame, shame,
USA, shame, shame, USA.
Again, you are not tired. Shame, shame, USA.
Shame, shame, USA.
Shame, shame, USA.
Shame, shame, USA.
Shame, shame, Israel. Who are behind all these scenes. Zionism is racism. Down with
Zionism.
Zionism is racism.
Zionism is racism.
Zionism is racism.
Zionism is racism.
Sham Sham USA.
Sham Sham Israel.
Sham Sham USA.
Sham Sham USA.
Sham Sham USA. And we have to show our love, inshallah. Nara Takbir. If you are not tired, just show that you love Rasulullah. Nara Risalah. Nara Takbir. Nara Takbir. Community members, brothers, sisters, kids, youth, and all those who came from far, from east end, from west end, from north, south, and from where. We thank the ajr is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reward is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah, we will disperse peacefully and we show the respect and the peaceful demonstration, inshallah. Give me the community leaders, the mosque leaders and activists.
That the video should be removed from YouTube. That all Canadians, regardless of faith, should discuss theological differences respectfully with each other. That all mosques, churches, synagogues, schools, universities, and house of worship impart to their youth respect for divine teachings and divine symbols. That all Canadians of faith stand together against the plan of the Zionists to divide us, as Zionists respect neither Judaism, Christianity, nor Islam. That all Muslims stand together and honor the Holy Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam as we honor other prophets of God, including Adam, Noah, Abraham, Moses, and Jesus. May God please and blessing be on all of them. So once again, brothers, thank you so much for coming. I would request you to please disperse peacefully.